So the first resource we're going to be talking about with working in math tools for students is a website called Mathway. And it's really great because it allows beginning students to either type in a problem like the one that showed up, or you can click on the content area and use a math keyboard to help you solve a problem. In addition, it gives you the various things that it can do, such as factoring the problem. When you do it, it shows you the answer, and if you go to a graph option, you can keep the same problem and continue to use it to find things like the slope or the intercept and an actual graph. And then if you have the pro version, you can get step-by-step tools to help you see where you went wrong and to check with your answer and where you went wrong. So it's a great tool for students to check what they're doing and right and wrong. And then the second resource that we are going to talk about is something called Wolfram Alpha.
Okay, so in Wolfram Alpha, so it's a little bit different from Mathway. So Mathway, it's good for beginner to use Mathway because you just put on the you just choose the topic. But however, the Wolfram Alpha, you have to type it in. Like example, if you like solving for x, you just type in solve for x. And then it can give you the format of how you're gonna input it. So it's gonna give you solve this equation equals zero, and this is the way you're gonna put it in. So example, you put it solve x the power of, and you can see how I put it in is a little bit different from. I put in how the computer can read it. X square equal 49. And then you press enter. It can give you, this is how you're gonna input it, and you give you the solution and also give you the graph. Okay? And you can type any topic, and you can just give you how you're gonna input in integration, differentiating, and I use it a lot, the Wolfram Alpha, and it really helped out with my homework. And even the integration, if you have like a lot of things in integration, you can just plug it in. But I think that the difference is Mathway is a little bit easy to use. And Mathway, you can also download in your iPhone. I have downloaded mine in my iPhone, and it really helps.
So with Wolfram, it's also really cool because you can add an extended keyboard, your image input, data input, and you can like upload pictures and everything. They give you examples and random stuff like that. And then with the last one, it's called Khan Academy. And a lot of people have actually used this for various subjects. If you go to this drop down, you can see based upon content, grade, and specific categories within the content. So what's really cool is if you click on a video, it keeps track of how far you've gone. So you can watch the video. And then there's also the transcript here, so you can follow along. Not only watching what he does in the problems like this, but also you can keep track of it by seeing where he's going in the problem in the screen that he has. So it's a great way to follow through with what the students are hearing and seeing. And then in addition, you can ask a question. There's different tips and comments that people have said. Once you watch the video all the way to the end, it gives you the option of energy points, which are later tracked. But after you watch the video, you can go on to the next one, and then eventually there's practice problems based upon what you learned. So you type in the answers and it gives you this drop down keyboard, and then you can go back to the video if you get stuck. You have this scratch pad that can allow you to actually write on the screen to help you with that. And there's hints, and then it keeps track. And then another really cool thing is Khan Academy will email you based upon what you did during the week. So it's a great way for teachers to keep track of what their students are doing in just a weekly email. So all of these resources are really good for helping students in the math world, whether it be Khan Academy, Wolfram, or Mathway. So they all allow you to better yourself in learning in a flipped classroom or in-class style. That was what we decided to focus on today.